what is, and I'll take one questions one by one, right? And if I don't take your questions, you can try it again. So the first question that I've got is, can I still prepare for prelims? So as far as I'm aware, prelims is on 2nd June, I guess, 2nd or 3rd June. So it's like 75-80 odd days are left. So if you're asking me that if you can still prepare for prelims from scratch, if you don't have any background or you don't even have any basics in place, then I would say no. Then it is very difficult to, because the time now is very less, right? So if you want to tell me that you have basics in place and then you can prepare for prelims 2019, then yes, you can prepare for prelims 2019, right? Okay, so any other question? Now, one very important question is actually, a lot of people don't focus on this, is how many questions you should ideally solve in paper, as in the pre. So I'll tell you something. A lot of people will suggest to you that solving around 65 to 70 questions is a good attempt, given that you have a very high accuracy rate. Now, the problem with this is a high accuracy rate would mean that if you are solving, say, 70 questions, a very high accuracy rate of, say, 80%, 70 questions, if you have an accuracy rate of 80, then also you will be getting around 56 correct. That is how many marks? 112. And you will be getting how many wrong? 14 wrongs. So, minus the negative, you will be below 100 or around 100, which is barely safe, right? So, the problem with this approach is that, you know, this leaves you on the fence. You're not sure that if you will get selected or not. My personal experience has been, I've given two prelims. I've cleared both the prelims, obviously. In first pre, I attempted 93 questions, and in the second pre, I attempted 97 questions. And this way, what happens is that even if you get, say, 20 wrong, still you'll end up getting 125, something like that. Right? So what happens this way is, in first attempt, when I attempted around 93 questions, I got 153 marks. The second attempt, I got 125 marks. Both the times, I scored much above the cutoff. Right? Hope it answers your question. So, any other question that you have related to pre, specifically, and pre 2019? Please, if I missed your question, you can type it again. Okay, sir, suggest books for culture and economics, I suppose you mean. Now, the problem is that we are addressing only pre-2019. So, if you're asking for pre-2019, if you're starting from scratch, it's too late anyways. See, this is, was supposed to be only for pre. Economic survey of this year, I don't think this economic survey is coming out this year. Okay, now I'll tell you what to focus on for the remaining 80 odd days for the pre, if you're writing pre this year. See, now that only 80 days or something are left, then I'll tell you the most important things for you, the two things very important that you have to do for 2 months is, number one, revise. Number two, solve questions. Now, you have to understand that solving question does not mean that you just solve question and if you get a question wrong, you see the answer and you move on. It is not that. What you have to do is that you solve a question. If you get an answer wrong, look at the answer, but go to the concept, revise the concept, and then move ahead. So this way, what you'll do is that you will use your question paper as a revision tool. Whatever you get wrong, you revise the entire concept, right? So this way, your exact question solving will also assist you in revision. You are revising, yes, but then you are also solving questions in form of revision. Now, how to solve a call question? Do you want to join test series, something like that? I'll tell you. What you have to do is that, apart from joining a test series, that too, if you wish to join a test series, it's fine. But if you don't want to join a test series, which is absolutely fine, because I never joined a test series for pre, you can go and buy 3-4 test series from the market, from 3-4 coaching centers. Solve at least two papers daily at your home. This way, you take around 2 hours to solve one paper, 4 hours for two papers, and around 2 hours to revise from the paper and whatever you got wrong, right? So 6 hours you give to question solving daily now. Rest of the time you can divide on revision and reading some things which you feel your weaknesses lay in, right? So this is the two most important things that you have to do right now for pre-2019. How to study IAS in college. Don't have to study for IAS in college time. I'll say focus on your college. It's very important. Okay, for science and environment portion for pre specifically, what I will suggest is that you only and only focus on current affairs, because environment and science and technology is anyways a very current oriented subject. What happens is that you have to be aware of the latest development in environment and science and technology. Now, when you study those monthly magazines of any coaching center, what happens is that they not just mention the current affair, but also the concept behind it, which is the static part. So you, when you study the monthly magazine, you end up revising that portion also, right? So you can do that. Okay, CSAT, the only way I would suggest to approach CSAT is to get previous years papers, like 4-5 previous years papers, and solve them. That's it. Why mostly aspirants do not crack prelims? See, prelims being an objective exam, the main problem, or I would say the main hiccup that people have is that it is, you either get a question right or you get it wrong, right? Unlike subjective, it does not matter that if you partially know the answer. That means that if in a subjective question, if you know say half the answer, you might end up getting like 20%, 25% marks. But in pre, if you get the answer wrong, you won't get any marks. As a matter of fact, you'll get negative marks. That's why it's very difficult to dodge objective papers. Right. I hope you guys are understanding me, and there's no problem with English. I've gotten a lot of requests that to address the session in English, because people, fellow friends from South India, not comfortable with Hindi. I've already answered how many questions to attempt in prelims. You can see the video when it's over. How to normalize the mind distractions. Just try and remember why you started the preparation in first place. Current affairs, you have to do three things. Number one, your newspaper. Number two, you have to read one monthly magazine of any coaching center that you prefer. Number three, go to the website Insights on India. I actually saw it after I cleared the exam, but it's very good. You can go and see it and just read the daily current affairs from there. You'll fill all the gaps. Mains exam, I'll talk when it comes. How to overcome depression? Well, I'm not a psychiatrist, so I'm really sorry I cannot answer this question. How to read Atlas? How to read Atlas? Okay. I don't know if it is related to pre, but I'll anyways answer it because it's a very important kind of question. Rather than how to read Atlas, I will answer the question how to prepare physical and maps, physical geography or maps. What you have to do is you have to get in the practice or in the habit of filling maps. Get Indian physical maps and world physical maps and start filling them. Filling them in the sense, get a set of 5 maps, fill 5 maps only with the world's mountain ranges, then fill 5 maps only with the world's most important rivers, fill 5 maps with only the important river bodies, national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, etc, etc. This way you will end up knowing every physical feature of India and important physical features of the world. Insights on India is a good website. Forum IS is also good. In 12th, focus on school. How to prepare for science and environment, I've already answered. Just see the video when it's over. IPC ki taiyari kaise shuru karein? It's the same exam, you prepare for the same exam. which thing should we read first, NCERT or reference books? It's your personal choice, it does not matter. But mostly 90% of the people read NCERT first. Hello sir, I'm in college first year. What is the correct college first year? Don't study right now for UPSC, wait for third year or fourth year. I am an IAS, which cadre is best? If you are an IAS, then you must have a cadre also. Talk about mains after pre. You've cleared pre twice, but mains is not clearing. Okay, you clear this time and then I'll guide you personally. What is the right way to read newspaper? Although this is not related to pre 2019, but I'll answer it. The right way to read newspaper is to know what not to read. You don't have to read political news, you don't have to read crime, you don't have to read local news, you don't have to read party politics and all that. You only have to focus on important things, just like policies, schemes, Indian economy and the macroeconomic indicators, Supreme Court judgment on constitutional matters, international relations and important happenings, art and culture, science and environment. That's it. You must not take more than 40-45 minutes. Level of mathematics which comes in pre is around 8th or 9th standard. It's very easy. If you are studying in 11th, focus on school. You cannot enter Lavasna unless you know someone here. How to remember articles? How to remember articles? Okay, the best way to remember articles is that there is a book called PM Bakshi. It's a very concise book, a core constitutional text. It can fit into your bag or anyways, you can carry it anywhere. Just keep it handy. Then wherever you get time, just go through important chapters of the Indian Constitution and just read the bare articles. This way you'll end up remembering every article by the time you give exam. Coaching institutes is not at all necessary. I can't speak in Hindi, but most of the people will not be comfortable with it. Coaching is not necessary. It's good. I mean, if you want to go for it, nothing bad in it, but it's not necessary. If you are fearful of examination hall, then the best way to get the fear out is solve a lot of questions with time in mind, or join a test series because they try and create the same atmosphere for you. Don't start preparation on second year, wait for third year or fourth year. If you want to prepare for economy for pre from scratch, it's too late. How to deal with economics? See, what I did for economics was that I relied a lot on the newspapers and I relied a lot on documents like budget, survey. There is a 12th five-year plans approach paper. So these things were the main tools that I used for economics. So if these things help you, you can do that as well. Geography is probably the best source of the NCERTs and JC Leong. First year students or college freshers or 12th or 11th students, I will right away say that this is not the right time for you to prepare. Never know what will happen in 3-4 years. You will end up forgetting everything and you will end up spoiling your college studies also. It's better to focus on college. It's also very important. And when the right time comes, you can start preparing for civil services. So I'm not getting questions related to prelims 2019 right now. I've already notified that this session was supposed to be on prelims 2019, and if you guys don't have any question related to that, then I guess it will it's not necessary for us to continue with the session. So these are very generic queries. We will do another session very shortly on these queries of yours. Prelims 2019, I've already told you what to do, what not to do for the remaining 80 days. And I'll try and do a session in which I'll try to take all these generic queries of yours. But today, I'll have to say that this will be all from my side. And if you want to ask me specific questions, message me on my profile. You can search it, you can see it from the post. Message me any query that you have, and I will definitely reply. I always reply. Okay, take care, guys. All the best.